Hello everyone, welcome to the most interesting topic in this section of Unit 2, which is interference. The topic is called as Newton rings. In this topic, we will cover the topics: what is Newton rings, Newton rings in reflector system, and as well as Newton rings in transmitter system. Why the Newton rings are formed as a circular fringes, why these rings are not uniform, and finally we will determine the wavelength of monochromatic source by using Newton rings. High focal length of plano convex lens L is placed on a glass plate P in such a way that lens curvature is in contact with glass plate. As a result, from the contact point O to edges of the lens, air film is formed in between them. So, with contact between plano convex lens and glass plate, when this system is illuminated with monochromatic light source, then concentric dark and bright rings will be formed. This can be viewed in this animation. When we increasing the number of the ring, then the width of the ring decreases. So, the width of the rings are not uniform, and these rings are called Newton rings. Why? Because these rings are circular. Because from the contact point O to the edge of the lens, the thickness of the air film is increasing. Here, lens is in circular shape, so the constant thickness of air film is achieved only in circular shape. Hence, as a result, these rings are circular. This can be viewed on this animation. Now we will discuss about the procedure. Consider the light rays coming from the source will incident on convex lens CL. This can be viewed on this animation. Now these light rays are incident on glass plate G as shown in this animation. Here the glass plate G is making 45 degree angle with incident light rays which are coming from CL. When the light rays are incident on glass plate G, then they split into two types of light rays. One is refracted and goes up to upside as shown in this animation. Assume that these light rays are one. Similarly, at G, the light rays reflected and goes vertically down. After this, these light rays are incident on this system, that is on plano convex lens. So after the incidence, these light rays reflect from the plano convex lens and plain glass plate system and undergo path change in between these. So these reflect rays directly goes vertically up. Assume that these light rays are 2. Hence, due to the path difference between the two light rays 1 and 2, they superimpose on each other and forms an interference pattern of Newton rings on plano convex lens. This can be viewed directly with our eye. For better quality of Newton rings, we can view with the help of microscope M. This can be viewed on this animation. Now we will discuss about the analysis of Newton rings. That means how the path difference happened in between the system. Lens L is placed on glass plate P in such a way that lens curvature is in contact with the glass plate at O. This can be viewed on this animation. As I said earlier, The light rays goes vertically down and incident on normally on the plane or convex lens. These light rays are reflected from lower surface of lens and refract to outside of lens. Assume this light ray is 1. Similarly, these light rays are refract from the lower surface of the lens and incident on glass plate. After the incidence of these light rays or reflect from glass plate and undergo multiple refractions and finally emerges from the lens. Assume this light ray is 2. Hence, due to the path difference between the two light rays 1 and 2, they superimpose on each other and forms an interference pattern of Newton rings. This can be viewed on this animation. Now, we will discuss about the determination of wavelength of monochromatic light source by using Newton's rings in reflected light system. But we know that when the plane or convex lens L is placed on glass plate P in such a way that lens curvature is in contact with glass plate at O, then air film is formed in between the plano convex lens and glass plate. Now consider nth dark ring XY in the air film. This seems to be a line in this system. But in reality, this XY ring will be a circle as shown in this animation. If you seeing from the surface of lens, that is up, then it actually looks like a circle. But if you are seeing from side, it actually looks as a line. Consider the diameter of this nth ring is dn. But we know that in Newton rings, the condition for nth dark ring in reflected light system is delta is equal to 2 mu t cos r is equal to n lambda. But here, mu is the refractive index of the air film, that is mu is equal to 1, and also the light ray incident normal to the lens, that is r is equal to 0 degrees, implies cos r is equal to 1. Therefore, from the above equation, can be written as 2t is equal to n lambda. Here, n means number, so the numbers we can take 1, 2, 3, so on. Assume this is first equation. Now if we extend the curvature of the plano convex lens, then it appears like a circle. This can be viewed on this animation. If C is the center of this circle, then AO becomes its diameter. Here the XY line and AO line meeting at point B. Now consider the radius of curvature of the circle. That means the lens curvature of radius is R. According to geometry, these lines meeting at the point B. So we can write as a XB into BY is equal to AB into BO. Here XB and BY represents the radius of the nth dark ring. So we can write AB into AO minus BO. BO means thickness of air film at nth dark ring. So put the above values. So the equation can be written as Rn into Rn is equal to AO minus BO into T. Here, AO means the diameter of the circle, so it becomes 2R. So we can write the above equation in such a fashion that Rn square is equal to 2R minus T into T. By solving this equation, we will get Rn square is equal to 2RT minus T square. Here, T is very small when compared to the radius of curvature capital R. Then we can neglect t square in the above equation. Therefore, we can write as a Rn square is equal to 2R into T. The above equation can be written as 2T is equal to Rn square by capital R. Assume this is second equation. From 1 and 2, we can remove 2T value. Then the new equation can be written as Rn square by capital R is equal to n lambda. Therefore, Rn square is equal to n lambda r. Assume this is third equation. The equation 3 is called radius of nth dark ring. From equation 3, we can evaluate the nth dark ring diameter. So, we can write dn square by 4 is equal to n lambda r. Therefore, Rn is equal to dn by 2. The above equation can be written as dn square is equal to 4n into lambda into r. Assume this is fourth equation. Since the diameter of the dark ring is always double of the radius of the dark ring, that's why I written rn is equal to dn by 2. This equation 4 is very important for us. This can be written as dn is equal to square root of 4n into lambda into r. This can be written as dn is equal to square root of n into square root of 4 lambda r. Here I separated n on the above equation. Here lambda and r are constants for given lengths and given monochromatic source. Hence, we can directly written as dn proportional to root n. This is in box. Here, n means number. So, the numbers we can take 1, 2, 3, so on. Hence, from the above expression, the ratio of dark diameters are in the ratio root 1, comma, root 2, comma, root 3 and so on. Hence, from the above expression, the widths of dark rings are not uniform. Moreover, as the dark ring number is increasing, the width of dark ring diameter decreasing. This can be viewed on this animation. Similarly, we can evaluate the mth dark ring diameter from equation 4. So, we can write as dm square is equal to 4m into lambda into r. Assume this is fifth equation. From 4 and 5, that means subtracting 4 in 5, then we can write as dm square minus dn square is equal to 4m lambda r minus 4n lambda r. In this equation, take common 4 lambda r, then dm square minus dn square is equal to 4 lambda r into m minus n. Solve the above equation. So, we can write as box lambda is equal to dm square minus dn square by 4 into capital R into m minus n. Assume this is sixth equation. From using boxed equation 6, we can find the wavelength of monochromatic source. Here, I evaluated the wavelength of monochromatic source by using the condition for dark rings in reflected light system. Similarly, we can evaluate the wavelength of monochromatic source by using the condition for bright rings in reflected light system. So, let's find out the expression for bright rings also. Here, also consider nth bright ring XY in lens. This can be seen in this animation. Let dn be the diameter of the bright ring. Hence, the condition for nth bright ring in reflected light system is delta is equal to 2 mu t cos r is equal to 2n plus 1 into lambda by 2 Here we can take n is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, so on. But here mu is a refractive index of air film, that is mu is equal to 1, and also the light ray which are incidenting normal to the lens, that is r becomes 0 degrees equal to cos r is equal to 1. From the above expressions, the equation can be written as 2t is equal to 2n plus 1 into lambda by 2. Assume this is first equation. But according to geometry, these lines meeting at the point B, we can write xb into by is equal to ab into bo. Here xb and by represents the radius of the nth bright ring. So we can write ab into ao minus bo. Bo means thickness of air film at nth bright ring. So the equation becomes Rn into Rn is equal to AO minus BO into T. Here, AO means the diameter of this circle, so it becomes 2R. So, the above equation can be written as Rn square is equal to 2R minus T into T. By solving this, we can write as Rn square is equal to 2R into T minus T square. Here, t is very small when compared to the radius of curvature of capital R. Then we can neglect t square in the above equation. Then we can write as Rn square is equal to 2 capital R into t. The above equation can be write as 2t is equal to Rn square by capital R. From 1 and 2, we can remove 2t value, then the equation becomes Rn square by capital R is equal to 2n plus 1 into lambda by 2. That implies Rn square is equal to 2n plus 1 into lambda into R by 2. Assume this is third equation. From equation 3, we can evaluate the nth bright ring diameter. So we can write dn square by 4 is equal to 2n plus 1 into lambda into R by 2. Since Rn is equal to dn by 2, the above equation can be written as dn square is equal to 2 into 2n plus 1 into lambda into R. Assume this is fourth equation. So equation 4 is very important for us. This can be written as dn is equal to square root of 2 into 2n plus 1 into lambda into R. So this can be separated as dn is equal to square root of 2n plus 1 into square root of 2 into lambda into R. Here I separated 2n plus 1 term on the above equation. Here lambda and R are constant for given lens and given monochromatic source. Hence, we can directly written as dn proportional to square root of 2n plus 1. Here, n means number. The numbers we can take 0, 1, 2, 3, so on. Hence, the ratio of bright diameters are root 1, root 3, root 5, so on. Hence, from the above expression, the widths of bright rings are not uniform. Moreover, as the bright number increases, the width of bright ring decreases. This can be viewed on this animation. So, in addition to this, the diameter of the dark ring dn proportional to root n and the diameter of bright ring is dn proportional to square root of 2n plus 1. From the above two expressions, it is clear that bright ring and dark ring widths are not equal. Either it is bright ring or it is dark ring. This can be viewed in this animation. In exam point of view, we need not to draw these rings, and moreover, no need to explain the widths of bright and dark rings. But the concept is very important That's why I explained to you. Now come to our exam point of view. So similarly, we can evaluate the nth bright ring diameter from equation 4. So we can written as dm square is equal to 2 into 2m plus 1 into lambda into r. Assume this is 5th equation. This can be viewed on this animation. From 4 and 5, that means subtracting 4 in 5, then we can written as dm square minus dn square is equal to 2 into 2m plus 1 into lambda into r minus 2 into 2n plus 1 into lambda into r. In this equation, 2 lambda r is common in the right hand side. So, in the right hand side, it becomes 4 lambda r into m minus n. Implies dm square minus dn square is equal to 4 lambda r into m minus n. So, from the above equation, we can written as box lambda is equal to dm square minus dn square by 4r into m minus n. Assume this is 6th equation. So equation 6 represents the wavelength of monochromatic source for the condition for the bright rings in reflected light system. Hence, if you take either bright rings or dark rings in reflected light system, the wavelength of monochromatic source is same. That is, box lambda is equal to dm square minus dn square by 4 capital R into m minus n. Now, we will discuss about the Newton's rings in transmitted light system. In transmitted light system, also air film is formed in between glass plate and lens, but at point O, there is no contact in between them. That means, without contact between plano-convex lens and glass plate. As a result, the light rays coming from air film are not faces any additional path difference. So, this is transmitted light system. So, the central ring becomes bright ring. So, as a result, the rings are formed as shown in this animation. That means, these rings are complementary. That means reverse to the reflected light system. As I discussed earlier in this video, here also the wavelength of monochromatic source in transmitted light system is same in reflected light system. That is, lambda is equal to dm square minus dn square by 4r into m minus n. So, this animation gives the short description for both reflected light system and transmitted light system. This is the complete description of Newton rings. Thank you. So, this is our topic. So, please subscribe our Telugu Gamanam channel for more lecture videos. Click the bell icon for notifications. If you want to get lecture notes for this lecture video, click the description link below in the lecture video. Thank you for watching this video. See you again in the next lecture video. Have a nice day. Thank you one and all.